Absolutely, because we need to ask for help. It's okay to ask for help. But also, in just our few moments, would you share some words of encouragement, maybe even just about self-care for families and caregivers who are taking care of our loved ones?
Aisha, I'm gonna do power in the
sometimes
name of Jesus.
You gotta put that mask on yourself and do
also known as bring every
reward
chain.
Reward yourself, right? Reward yourself. Whether it's ice cream, a walk, a date night, whatever that looks like. Be strengthened today. Be encouraged today. Know that you are not alone. There is the website, National Autism Association. National Autism Association. You can go there for resources and help. And hey, listen, if you see this beautiful lady around here, just know that she loves you. She's praying for you. And if you want to reach out to her and just ask her for a word of encouragement, she is our very own. She is our family at this church. But listen, today we are going into the presence of the Lord. If you're in the room, just go ahead and jump up on your feet. If you're online with us, won't you join us? Today is a great day to give God the praise. We love you, family. Let's go.
Hallelujah. It is a great day to glorify the name of our God, because there is still power. There's still resurrection power. There's still healing power in the name of Jesus. Do you know that there's still power to save, power to heal, power to deliver, power to set free, power to redeem, power to restore?
faithful to complete it. We'll be faithful today. I welcome you. If you don't feel welcome, I really can't help you, but there's a presence of the Lord in here that should make everybody feel welcome. He's in the room. Church that don't seek after the presence of God, because I don't care how good you sing, it ain't good enough to break a yoke.
Just don't spit up on our carpet.
The wall will come down. Hallelujah. You brought the other wall down.
Don't hit the back.
Bring this one down too. It's going to come down in Jesus' name and in his perfect timing when it is safe. And it's going to be a blessing. We're going to have room to increase. Tell somebody we need more room. Because you're faithful, it's because you give, it's because you put God first. You can always see where your money goes to work at the Potter's House of North Dallas. We're grateful. We're grateful to be givers. We're grateful to be people that understand the principle of God. And God has blessed us because of that. Today, if you have your tithe is 10%. Whatever God has given you, you owe him 10%. And it's even people that may not even come to the church. People that have businesses understand that there's a principle that happens when we give back. How many of you know that?
Yes.
You got to know that. So today I want you to get your tithe. I want you to get an offering together in your hand, and we're going to lift it up before the Lord. If you want to give on your devices, you can, because all that information is on the screen. If you're at home, you can do the very same thing. If you're in the building and you want to put it in an envelope and actually bring it down here and lay it on the altar, you can do it that way. If you want to put it in the box on your way out the door, you're free to do that. Any way you bless the Lord in your giving, it'll be all right today. Amen. I want those of you that have your tithe, your offering, I want you to lift it up in your device or the envelope, whatever you have, just lift it up high. If you're in this room and you say, I need a blessing, I need a job this week, Pastor Brady, lift up your hand, lift it up. We've had some people get jobs this week. Y'all remember us praying about it last week? We prayed about it, and there's some people that got jobs this week. We're going to continue to believe God. We're not going to forget about that because I understand you need that. Lift it up high. Lift your hand up high. If you just want to be under this prayer, I want you to stand because I want to pray for you. Father, in the name of Jesus, what a privilege and what an honor it is for us to bring to your house the first fruits of our increase. You have blessed us. Lord, and today we want to bless you back. We bless you back by tearing off the portion that belongs to you. And today, we mark this as a time of worship. This is not a time that we just get things out of the way. This is a time of worship. It's a time when we say, thank you for the strength to bless us, to gain increase. Thank you for the strength to go to work. Thank you for the opening of jobs for us. Thank you for being the food on our table that you have been. Thank you for being a counselor late in the midnight hour. Thank you for being direction for our feet. Thank you for opening every door that you've opened for us. Thank you that we're not going to miss you, but you're going to move so clearly and so precisely in our lives that we'll say, this is the way, walk ye in it. We pray for increase, God. Even as Jabez prayed for increase, we pray for increase, that you would bless us. Bless us in the city. Bless us in the field. Bless us going in. Bless us coming out. We cry out for the blessing of Jehovah to be on our house, our family, and our lives. And we ask you to do it today. And we ask it in the name of Jesus. Somebody shout amen. If you're a giver, shout amen. If you are at home, you know how to give. The instructions are on the screen. And while they're coming, I just want to say how grateful I am today to have the bishop in the house looking. Oh, got to get up today. You better get up. He's cute and he's mine, okay? He's cute and he's mine, and I love him today. I'm thankful to all of our leaders, to all of our elders, to all of those who serve in this house. Come on, better clap for everybody else too. Come on. It ain't just the bishop that's special. It ain't just the pastor. Come on, it's everybody. We couldn't do anything without those of you that are here, that are serving. And what I love about this church is that y'all serve the Lord with gladness, and that's an important thing. I want to ask you to jump back up on your feet for a minute, then we're going to let you sit down as soon as our praise team and worship team takes us just a little bit further. Pastor Sanchez, where are you at today? Hey, y'all, this is a wonderful man of God and his wife. Is this your daughter? Oh, my Lord. These people used to be a part of our staff at the river when we were in North Carolina. They're here visiting us today. Can y'all make them feel welcome? We're so grateful y'all are here. They are faithful people, and we're glad that they are with us today. And as I prepare to move out of your way, I'm going to ask you, you know, we began our series about resetting prayer in our life, and I want to encourage you, if there's ever been a time to pray, this is the time that we should pray. This week, I want you to pray for peace in the Middle East. We need that to calm down. We need that to cease in the name of Jesus. And we are going to, how many of y'all will pray and agree that God will bring peace everywhere? Okay, everywhere in the world. That need to be released, right? We want to pray for the peace in the Middle East, and we're going to pray that God be glorified in some way, that God will be glorified and the devil will be horrified at the prayers of the righteous. Do you know when you sound of your voice, and he'll try everything he can to shut it up. But you ought to holler right now to let him know, no, 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 no. I will lift my voice. He has caused me to triumph in every area of my life. So we want to pray for leaders around the world as well.
Yes.
And Pastor Travis is going to come momentarily and bring us the word of the Lord on prayer today. Do y'all thank God for the pastors in this house? Pastor Travis, Pastor Jeremy, Pastor Joseph, Pastor Tina, Pastor Lana. We want to thank God for all of them who serve this body diligently. And so I thank God for you. I want you to just lift your hands and say, Lord, take me higher.
Lord, take
me. Come on, tell them again, take me higher. Come on, Pastor.
Two, one, two, three. now, Jay. Now flow with it, flow with it, flow with it. Let's go, Josh. Make sure Josh is on the stage.